Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the video. Today, I'm going to be breaking down Mr. Joey Belladonna of Anthrax. Let's do it. Joey Belladonna was born Joey Belladini in Oswego, New York. He's Italian-American on his father's side and Native American on his mother's side. In his youth, Belladonna looked up to bands such as Led Zeppelin, The Beatles, Kansas, and Rush. All bands that Joey Belladonna described as having stuff that was very intricate yet catchy and hooky, and having great vocals. As anybody who isn't new to my channel will know, my favourite singer of all time is Eric Adams from Manowar, with whom Joey actually shares a connection. In 1983, Joey joined the band Bible Black, formed by former Elf and Rainbow members Craig Gruber and Gary Driscoll, as a replacement for their former vocalist, a man named Eric Adams. Also known by his birth name as Louis Marullo, who had just left to go and join a new band called Manowar. Joey recorded the songs Deceiver and Midnight Dance with Bible Black, but the band never actually officially released them on an album. After his time with Bible Black, Joey went on to land a place in a band that he is most well known for, Anthrax, in 1984. He was with the band from then until 1992, and he's considered part of their classic lineup, and also my personal favourite singer for Anthrax. After parting with Anthrax in 92, being replaced by John Bush, Joey spent most of the next decade touring around in minivans and taking jobs wherever he could. He also started working on his solo career with his self-titled project, Belladonna, releasing the self-titled debut album in the mid-90s to a good reception from both fans and critics. The subsequent two albums, however, were heavily criticised for not having very good production and just not being great in general. In early 2010, and not a moment too soon, Joey officially rejoined Anthrax in time for the Big Four show at Sonosphere Festival, and continued afterward to return to the studio with Anthrax to record vocals for their long-awaited album, Worship Music. Since his return, Anthrax have been nominated for 3 additional Grammy Awards, which says a lot about the talent of that particular lineup. Today I'll be breaking down Joey's vocals in 4 parts: range, tone, technique, and longevity.
Range. Joey has a range from a G2 in Vice of the People. To a B-flat 5 in Imitation of Life. This makes his range 3 octaves and 3 semitones. This is a surprisingly small range for a man who can wail as high as Joey, but not a bad range at all. Joey can hit some lower notes as well as the powerful high screams he and heavy metal are famous for. Based on his tone and range, I believe Joey is a tenor and a very good one. A lot of his upper middle register is very well connected and powerful, meaning his high range is pleasing and isn't just unmusical squeaking. All in all, it seems as though Joey definitely makes use of all 3 octaves and 3 semitones. Tone. Joey has a very warm, yet deep and resonant tone, embodying a lot of the operatic principles such as good squealer and vibrato. It's no wonder to me that Joey began his career in a band filling the shoes of Eric Adams, as he also has such a powerful voice, well-covered sound, and provides projection and a floating timbre to his higher notes. Technique. Once again, Joey is a great example of a heavy metal singer with a healthy respect for the opera. This is pretty much the sole reason his tone is so pleasing to hear, as he, like Eric, Ronnie Dio, and Bruce Dickinson, has spent many years perfecting a technique based in the operatic method, which is also evidenced by how he's still able to deliver the goods in his 60s better than most pop artists in their 20s and 30s. Joey also has a smoothness to his voice that shows perfect breath control, especially when moving through his register from low to high and back again during live performances.
You're in for a surprise. We're in for a surprise.
All in all, if there is a man on this earth who has a technique that means he can sound only like himself and yet simultaneously like Ronnie James Dio, then that man's name is Joey Belladonna. Longevity. As proven by the fact that he is still going strong in his 60s at the time of recording of this video, Joey's longevity is great. Once again, another powerful metal voice who screamed his way into his bus pass years with more vigour than people half his age. Joey's example is not a rare one either, with heavy metal sporting the biggest repertoire of people in their 60s who've been at this business for over 40 years that are still going just as strong as when they started, and even stronger than some people, like I said before, half their age.
And there we have it! The man, the myth, the heavy metal legend, Mr. Joey Belladonna of Anthrax. Thank you all very much for watching this video. Please rate, comment, and subscribe, and let me know in the comments below what you thought and what singer you would like to see me break down next. Until then, I shall see you all in the next video.